Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition Blind.
A simple matter.
A simple matter. I'm Amethyst Lunatari.
You need something, stranger?
There were stores of iron ore stockpiled together through lean times, but something is wrong with it. Anything smelted becomes brittle within days. It's like the metal is diseased somehow. It makes it impossible to keep weapons and armor in good repair. Now we're in Beregost. Only found our way here. Is there blood? That's blood on that door. There's a commoner and a commoner.
Something on your mind?
Our smith Taram has been hit pretty hard by the iron shortage. His prices have only gone up because of it. Normally he is so reasonable, and better work you won't find anywhere. If you need any weapons and armor, he's the man to see. There are many rumors around Beregost about the scarcity of iron. Oh. You guys having an argument? Take that as a yes.
You'll feel the sting of my boot if you bother me further.
I take it that's your favorite line. Oh. We talked to her before. Alright, who or what is in here with the bloodstained door? We simply have to see. Oh, it's locked. I think we did try to get in here. Alright, I think Feldepost is down this way? Town crier.
Hear ye, hear ye!
By order of his most radiant of Lathander Keldath Ormlier, governor of Beregost, and in the best interest of its peoples, forthwith there be a bounty placed upon the head of the mad cleric Basilis for the crimes against nature that he has committed. Anyone bringing proof of his demise to the Song of the Morning Temple shall receive no less than 5,000 gold. Hear ye, hear ye. Basilis the murderer. The townsfolk of Beregost talk of a monster named Basilis was murdered. Many innocent folk. Keldath Ormlier is offering a bounty of 5,000 gold on a man named Basilis. I should be able to find Keldath in the Temple of Lathander just east of Beregost.
I'm actually quite shy.
Okay, I'll make a note of it.
Hear ye, hear ye.
Something on your mind?
Good day to you. So you ever heard of all the trouble brewing in the south? Aw, you probably don't care. You don't look like the political type. I think you've misjudged us. We're as interested in politics as the next person. So what's this trouble you were just talking about? Well, from what I've heard, there's some tension between the nation of Am and the city of Baldur's Gate. I've heard that the Grand Dukes of Baldur's Gate think that Am's behind all the iron troubles along the coast. Some people have even gone as far as to say that Am might be preparing to invade. I think it's just the usual rumor-mongering that goes on from time to time, but then, you never know.
You need something, stranger?
'Twas some 300 years hence, but folks still cringe at the mention of the destruction at the Old Castor School. I've not met a soul who claims to know why it occurred, and none that were there are alive to say. Sorry, guys.
Something on your mind?
We've heard that one. So this is Feldepost's Inn. We'll take a look.
Here now, get out! I don't like your type in here.
What? Who the hell are you?
You tell him, Marl.
Why don't you like my type in here?
Fine.
Are you talking to me?
Hey!
Are you talking to me?
I told you to get lost. Ain't no room here for your troublemaking strangers. I'll go where I like, pal. You got a problem with that? I have a problem with morons armed to the teeth, poking through ruins and stirring up creatures better left alone. Chokers like you blow through town with monsters in tow, and then out again, leaving us locals to clean up the mess. I don't know if I want to buy everyone around. I just do what I think is right. We solve a lot more trouble than we cause. Well, very nearly anyways. Ah! You think it's funny, do you? You mess up the local economy with your treasure. You upset the balance of nature. You flash your magic around, and because of it, maybe somebody's son thinks it's fun and goes out and gets himself killed. It's a bad example, and somebody ought to kick your ass for it. Hold on. Everyone gets their own path, and I'll not be held accountable for what the fates deal. He was a good boy till your kind came through town. Fill his head with that nonsense they did, and because of it, he's dead. Now why shouldn't I take that out of your hide? Okay, so this is actually a real-life thing that happened. I thought he was talking about a hypothetical. If you knew him like you think, then ask yourself if he wouldn't have gone anyway. It's a calling you were born with. Nobody gives it to you. Tain't true. He was gonna take over the farm and settle down. Maybe apprentice with Thunderhammer during the winter. He never wanted to adventure. Duncan says, that was what you wanted, Marl. Fun's fun, but you're blaming these folk for what couldn't be helped. That boy was a firebrand if ever there was. No, he was settling down. He wanted... That new plow you bought last year, he got the gold by helping clear kobolds near Olgoth's beard. He wanted to make a difference, make the realms a bit safer. Just like these folk, most likely. By Chaunty, why couldn't he just stay home? Final buy around. The realms call, and you go. He sounds like a fine lad taken too soon, but doing what he was meant. If you'll suffer my company, I'll buy around and toast his memory with you. 'Twould be fitting, I suppose. To Kenner and Nethelin, rest you well. I would be alone a while. Well, 'tis the calmest I'd done seen him in a week, Duncan says. Still, best you move along. Marl ain't known for his steady moods. Journal updated. Marl's loss, and we gain 900 experience. That's a fair bit of experience for this level. A man named Marl tried to pick a fight with me at Feldepost Inn, but I was able to calm him down. Marl lost a son named Kenner Nethelin, an adventurer.
Hey, friend. Good to meet a fine sod such as yourself.
It'll be a cold day in the lower plains before I risk my neck in the elven ruin of Faerûn. Who knows what lurks around in these tight passages? I could barely stand two abreast in there. Tight enough to be a tomb. And for many, a man, it is a tomb. Where's Duncan?
Are you talking to me?
You're out of my face,
lest I... Are you talking to me?
Lest I smash it. Just be smart and listen to the man, okay? I just brought you around, okay, whatever.
Life's been getting prickly on me, Ars.
The more puzzling thing I've ever never heard. I was left for dead by the raiders, and a stranger healed me. Had the worst visage I ever hoped to lay eyes on, but his bearing I cannot question.
Hey, friend. Good to meet a fine sod such as yourself.
I hear that to prove you've actually taken his head, you have to produce Basilisk's holy symbol. Not that I ever touch it of my own free will. He's one of Sirik's boys. They are just not right in the head. Talk to Duncan.
Leave me be, or the guard will have you.
Oh, why? A friendly one. I have merchant relatives that routinely make the trip along the Coastway Road. They have said that the route they travel is normally bustling. Surely this could be a veritable floodgate of iron if the need were great. Interesting. She gives me that information and also threatens to call the guard on us. Strange people here. Hephis? Excuse me. 99 tankards of ale on the wall. 99 tankards of ale. Take one down and pass it around. 98 tankards of ale on the wall. Kind of doesn't go with the song they're playing right now. Alright, let's talk to Duncan.
Hey, don't click me! I don't want any trouble!
Seriously? I don't think my friend Mara likes you. It'd probably be wise if you left. We go where we like. I got a magic missile with his name on it. Oh, do I?
What?
Yes, I actually do have a spare magic missile with his name on it. Bartender!
Fine.
I got some cheap beer for ya.
Keep a low profile, if you please. Tempers are short for strangers right now. So what do you want? What do you have to offer? Well, these fire agachems. Only with 5 each. Oh, we have girl berries. Look at that. Ooh, look at that. History of the Fateful Coin. Grabbing that. Sapphire has a weak spot for bucks. Plus 2 arrows. You only buy them 2 each? Reflected image spell. Look at that. Dragon's Heart Ruby. This ruby looks like any other ruby, but as you look into its depths, the face of a dragon can clearly be seen peering back at you. Interesting. Well, it's way out of our league. Gillian?
Do you mind? I'm off to go shopping.
Ooh, hello. You must join me for a while, I insist. Where to go shopping? When a lady offers me a drink, how can I refuse? You are the life of the party, you are. This all reminds me of a time when Betsy and I were still... Whew, I'm so silly. I don't know all about Betsy. Hick. Oh, here's the cook.
Yes?
Hey, you stays out of my kitchen. You mess up my art. Someday I's gonna cook for the Duke himself. Bet you there are less fistfights in the palace, so as you can enjoy a meal from start to finish. Well, let's take a look upstairs then, shall we? Much quieter up here.
Such menial tasks.
Don't mind if we do. There's somebody in here. Hi. Algernon. Might we have a flower to give you?
What you want?
This is my room, and I don't want visitors. Now leave me alone. Okay. At least you're not wishy-washy about it. something of interest. Hello, traveler.
Hey, get out of me, will you, crummy loghead?
Hey. Might have all the rooms for you if you please. I paid for mine in full and don't feel I should need to double up, as it were. Alright. Alright, Feldepost in, everybody. Now,
a simple matter.
But this guy might have. Lily said this guy might have an elixir of belladonna. Maybe I missed it.
You want some whiskey?
I can get some rumors. Beregost and dark wine. No rumors? No, I didn't miss it. I mean, we do have the girl berries here, but traditional remedies in Faerûn and are used for various applications. They're especially popular to alleviate sufferings of the special type, which is why these berries are often offered by stores in vicinity to courtesans. It was the belladonna that had a better chance of being successful, so maybe we'll hold out for that. For curing our friend's
Fine.
Werewolf husband.
Yes?
Kagen shop, house of Alana's neighbor, the burning wizard. Well, let's make our way around here anyway. Clear all the fog off here.
What is it? What? Fine.
Locked. Damn it. Then all these locked doors.
Yes? Fine.
We need a fighter type to force stuff.
What is it?
Yep.
Doesn't she know? Thieving.
Gotcha.
What is this? Find traps, detect illusion. Oh, it succeeded!
What? Fine. A simple matter.
Hello? Anybody home?
What you want?
F5.
Gotcha.
All right.
Yes, fine. Fine.
Short sword. Oh. Better than nothing, I guess. Well, wait, there's something else here. Oh, 35 gold. We need it. For the cause and all that.
Such menial tasks. Fine.
Okay, how about this then?
Name it.
I name this.
You can count on me.
As you fail. Oh, succeeded.
What is it? A simple matter? A simple matter?
Good to go? Gotcha.
What? A simple matter?
Nothing much in here. I mean, except for whatever might be in there.
Such menial tasks.
Well, maybe we can open those other houses. Whoever successfully robbed by us, it'll be a lesson to them. They should keep their stuff more secure.
Yes?
If a city watch cannot protect us from raids, then what am I paying tax for? I'd be better off hiring mercenaries than trying to rely on the city guards. Nobody is fool enough to want to guard my caravans, though. Cowards all. Guess I'll just wait out the crisis here. Whatever you like. Guess we'll come back up here into the center of town. There's some places that we could not pick our way into. Like this. Oh, wait, is it unlocked now? No, it's locked.
Something up? Gotcha.
Yes, such menial tasks.
Hi. Oh. Thanks for leaving the room.
Fine.
Hurry up! Gotcha.
These style chests are very hard to get into. Now that we're done with that. Hi.
Yeah?
Oh, you startled me. I'm not used to strangers because traveling is so dangerous now. Please don't linger too long here. The children are leery of anyone they don't know, and 'tis hard enough keeping them calm when there's just me around. If only my husband hadn't gone to work the mines at Nashkel. These people don't really care if anyone goes in their stuff.
What is it?
You too.
A simple matter. What? Fine.
I thought that was a house of murder and vile deeds. Does it look like it had blood on it?
Yep.
Yes.
You can count on me.
Got it.
Yes. A simple matter.
Elaine?
Such menial tasks.
You said something?
Welcome, my dear. You are early. I... Excuse me. Indeed, I was expecting visitors, but none such as you. Begone, before my company arrives. I should not tolerate the mood being ruined by a band of miscreants.
What you want? You can count on me.
I serve the flaming fist!
You there! Stop where you are, thieves! You're under arrest for robbery. I represent the flaming fist and the law of the Grand Dukes. Wait one moment. We can pay you money. How about 100 gold to let us alone? Don't insult us with bribes! Reputation is decreased by 1. Oh. No, apparently we're gonna be killed. Okay.
Good on you if you save the day.
I am the law.
Okay. I am the law. Okay, Judge Dredd.
Fine.
They're gonna come after us no matter what, or just because we opened that?
Fine.
Silver ring. That's empty. Oh, wait. I'm just forgetting this one on the side. That's empty anyway.
Such menial tasks.
So we'll not open that. We'll just talk to him
you
like we did.
Something.
Band of miscreants. Alright, we'll be on our way.
Fine.
The Burning Wizard. Oh, this Firebeat Elven here's house over there. Can we get in there? So yeah. No spoilers, please, if you guys are watching it after, but all you've seen for Baldur's Gate 3 is the trailer where there was a man who's apparently, yeah, turned into an Illithid Mind Flayer, and he was a member of the Flaming Fist.
Something on your mind?
Yeah, Basilisk's holy symbol. Where's the entrance? Okay, here.
It's a hard to find decent folk nowadays.
Ah, you're old Garion's ward. The lonely kid of Candlekeep. Of course, I heard about the loss of Garion, and I must give you my deepest condolences. I hope since you've left Candlekeep, you've kept up on your reading. Oh, the world of books. Unfortunately, I'm not able to bring any books with us. Did find a few, though. I have heard that a new copy of that wondrous tome, The History of the Fateful Coin, can be had for a pretty penny in one of the stores around here. If you'd be so kind as to buy it for an old man like myself, I'd gladly reimburse you. I'd even give you a little bonus to help in your travels. It must be so hard with Garion gone. Hey, Mr. E. Remember me? I'm the second kid at Candlekeep. We're going to get your book, no problem. Imoen, glad to see you, lass. Forgive me for not recognizing you immediately, but you have changed. Sure thing, sir. No more aprons and bonnets for Imoen the Magnificent. Well, unless someone offers me a dragon's treasure hoard to wear one. We're going to get your book, no problem, Mr. E. It's good to see a familiar face, eh, Sapphire? I've met an old friend in Beregost. Firebead Elven here. An elderly mage who visited the library at Candlekeep on occasion has asked me to check out the stores in the area and purchase a copy of The History of the Fateful Coin for him, should I ever set eyes on it. Confining as its walls could be, there are days when I miss Candlekeep with every bone and every ounce of flesh in my body. All that, huh? This, I guess, is just going to be one of those days. Okay. Well, I do have that book. bought it for myself.
A simple matter.
I'll give it to him in time. I just want to make sure I can read it first.
A simple matter.
Ooh, what do we have? A jade ring. Thanks. 38 gold. We might need it more than you do. Jade ring. Oops. Just tells us what rings are. Okay. I wonder how to solve the mystery of the ooze. The man who was turned into an ooze. Now that we attacked it, I mean...
Such menial tasks.
I mean, if I leave Imoen outside, she won't kill it. I'm not sure... Oh. Where is he? He just disappeared, this guy. Hmm. Don't have much time for anything else, but let's go take a look around. Can we go in here? What is this?
Fine.
Something on your mind?
Hey! Shut your potato trap and give your tongue a holiday. I don't want strangers in my business. Shove off before I can take offense to your face. Oh my. Rude son of a...
A simple matter.
Hail.
Me youngins are waiting.
Oh, Mother Shirley is not gonna like you poking your nose in here. Strangers in her kitchen. She'll not likely let that pass unnoticed. Okay. History of the Drow. A boy.
Fine.
Loser, loser, loser!
Nice kid. Sleeping man. Is he gonna tell on us if we take that book? History of the Last March of the Giants. History of the Moon Sea. Nice. Loving it. Was a trap there? Interesting. Still, this boy here, though. Even if we undo a trap, that might be viewed as an offense.
A simple matter. Fine.
Oh, what's in here? Another set of leather armor. Oh, I'm full, aren't I? Someone hold on to some of these books for me. Use these rings too. Here, have a skull. Nasty old thing. The skull, not you. We can sell this armor. Oh, thanks. Is this a separate? Is that all one? So,
yes,
well, that's that rude guy again.
Hello, mate. You look a friendly face.
Pleasant day to you all. My, you all look rather handsome decked out in your adventuring garb. That's what you are, isn't it, adventurers? Well, I don't know what you're doing in our little town. From what I hear, the real excitement's happening down in Nashcal. What's been going on down in Nashcal? From what I've heard, there's some sort of trouble happening at the mine southeast of there. Let's see. Oh.
Fine. Fine.
Oh, crap. One of them came out of here.
What? Fine.
They all came out.
Yes? A simple matter.
Run!
What is it?
I don't have any charges left on here. I thought I did.
A simple matter.
Crap. I don't think I can get around these things.
Fine.
When was my last save again?
I am wounded.
Yeah. You could say that.
Such menial tasks.
Do we get the book? Alright. Alright, don't go into that house. At least not yet.
A simple matter.
We need a bigger party to take those spiders on.
Such menial tasks.
I know. It was better than being killed by spiders. I sense that we're gonna find something, and you should hold on to these books and rings for me. How about the sword, too? And the nasty skull. Deja vu. Somehow I feel I've done all this before, but yet I haven't. Have I?
Mate, you look a friendly face.
You look the sort that likes flashy weapons and trinkets. You should go see Thalantir west of town. Sure, he's grumpy, he might even have his pets attack you, but he usually calls them off if you take the time to talk to him. He's got a lot of magical wares for sale, though he acts like he's doing you a favor, taking your gold. Yes, we've seen him. Okay, spiders in there, I think. The Jovial Juggler.
Something on your mind?
Simple logic says there must be magic treasure in the ruins of a magician's school such as Oldcaster, but 'tis a treacherous task to get to it. Dead wizards are not known to sleep soundly, nor to wake jovial. We've heard rumors of an ancient wizard school with all sorts of treasures. Guess next episode, yeah, the Jovial Juggler. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.